A few months ago I reviewed the updated Bayangtoys X16 brushless quadcopter with GPS. While I was happy with it overall, mine proved practically unusable for aerial photography of any kind due to severe vibrations. Recently I decided to have another go at this by installing a camera gimbal on the quadcopter. In this video, I'll document that process along with some of the challenges and pitfalls I ran into along the way. At least in this context, a gimbal refers to a motorized stabilization and anti-vibration device designed to keep the camera level. I'm using a 3-axis gimbal, meaning it can stabilize the pitch and roll as well as yaw axis. It cost me around $75, but it's not specific for this quadcopter and can therefore be reused in future projects. Simpler 2-axis gimbals are available for significantly less. Okay, let's get started. As for how to power the gimbal, I considered a couple of different solutions, like using a separate battery, though this would add additional weight and bulk to the setup, or soldering a lead to some connection point on the quadcopter's flight board, though this would require taking the quadcopter apart. As my goal was to keep the modifications of the quadcopter itself to a minimum, I ultimately settled on a variation of the latter and made a custom cable, along with a small hole in the battery door, to allow powering the gimbal from the balance plug of the quadcopter's battery. As implied by the name, the balance plug, found on practically all multi-cell batteries, is really intended for accessing and balancing the individual cells of the battery, but can be used for powering things as well, which may be convenient with lower current equipment on the side. By using the outermost wires and cutting the others off to not make connection with each other or something else, it's possible to draw from all, in this case, 3 cells of the battery. 3S means 11.1 volts nominal voltage, which lies within the operating range of this gimbal. As for how to mount the gimbal, I initially tried to attach the base plate of the gimbal to the shoe mount of the quadcopter's originally included camera mount, but that didn't really pan out, so instead I resorted to the less elegant solution of just using a pair of Velcro tie-down straps. As the X16's legs were too short for the gimbal to hang freely, I extended them slightly using some foam-like material I had laying around. At this point, I also mounted my camera to the gimbal, an SJCAM SJ4000. As an obvious GoPro clone, it has almost the exact same dimensions as one, which is good since it meant I could use the strap that came with the gimbal. Remember to balance the gimbal for best possible results. As for configuration, I'd heard these gimbals tend to come pretty well pre-configured for GoPro type cameras, but still connected to the gimbal controller using the companion software, as I wanted the camera to tilt slightly downwards instead of straight ahead. For now, I left all of the hundreds of other options and parameters of the firmware unchanged. Alright, the gimbal is mounted, powered, and seems to be working. Let's test it out. At first, the quadcopter wouldn't let me unlock the motors with everything connected, but initializing the quadcopter completely before connecting the gimbal to the battery somehow solved this issue. Overall, I'm happy with the result, especially considering this was shot in very windy conditions. Of course, tweaking the gimbal controller configuration or balancing the quadcopter's propellers could improve things even further, but compared to the before footage, I think you'll agree it's already a case of night and day. This was my project of adding a gimbal to a toy-grade multirotor from beginning to end. Despite not going into much detail, I hope it still gave you some idea of the steps and challenges involved. Thank you for watching, and see you soon when we return to the regularly scheduled programming.